In this video, I'll be showing you how to create PIPOINTs for the PI interface for OPC DA. So just a quick side note before we begin, you might have heard the term PI tag instead of PIPOINT, but these mean exactly the same thing on the PI system. I'll be using the term PIPOINT throughout the video. So right now we're at the point where we have created our new PI interface instance, and this instance is now running. So here we have our PI message log open, and we can see from this PI message log that no PIPOINTs have been created for our PI interface yet. So I'm going to show you two ways to do this. The first will be how to create a single PIPOINT using PI system management tools. But before we begin, of course I need to bring up security again. We need to make sure that the user that'll be creating the PIPOINTs has write access to the PIPOINT table. Okay, so to start, first we need to choose which data we'll be collecting, so we need to go back to our PI OPC Client tool. So I need to connect to my OPC server and create a group. And these are all the same methods that I showed you in the previous video on how to check your OPC server using the PI OPC Client tool. So now I'll browse my OPC server and find the item that I want to collect data for. I'll add this to my group and hit OK. And here is what I need to create my PIPOINT. I need to know the type and the item ID of my OPC item. So make sure to take a screenshot here or to write this down. Okay, so now I can close this. And I also need to remember what my point source and my interface ID were for my new PI interface instance. Okay, so now we're ready to go to PI System Management Tools. We need to go into Points and Point Builder in order to create a new PI point. The first thing to choose is the name. Most PI system administrators have a naming convention that they follow when they create PI points. So for example, the name of the plant, the name of the unit, and the name of the attribute. Next, I need to change the point source to the correct source. So if you'll remember, my point source is GBX. Finally, I need to make sure that this point type is compatible with the data type that's on the OPC server. The PI interface for OPC DA user guide has a section that explains specifically which data types on the OPC server will be compatible with which data types on the PI data archive. So if you'll remember, my data type is VT_I4, which means a 4-byte integer. This corresponds to int32 on the PI data archive. Okay, so these are all the things that I need on the general tab, but I might want to fill in a couple more things, just as best practice. The first is the descriptor. So I want to give my users a bit more context when they're reading this PIPOINT. I also want to put in my engineering units. So this again will give my users context. They'll know what my value means. Finally, I can also change the display digits. This is the parameter that controls how numerical values are displayed in our PI clients. A negative number means that's the number of significant digits that'll be displayed, whereas a positive number means this is the number of digits that'll be shown after a decimal. So in my case, I'm going to change this to 3 significant digits, which is -3. Okay, so now I'm ready to go to the archiving tab. So this is where all the parameters that are important for archiving are set. The most important here are exception and compression parameters. You won't want to leave this as default, so if you need information on how to choose these, please check out the OSIsoft exception and compression full details video on the OSIsoft channel. You can also find more information on all these parameters in the PI Data Archive System Management Guide. Okay, so now we're ready to go to the Classic tab. So these are all the most important parameters for when we're configuring a PI point for the PI interface for OPC DA. So let me open up the user guide. So you'll find details on all these parameters in the Configure PI Point for the PI OPC DA interface section right here. So make sure to refer to this guide if you have any questions. Okay, so the first thing I'll want to put in is the instrument tag. This needs to correspond to the OPC item ID that I told you about earlier. So this is how my PI interface for OPC DA is going to be able to find my item on the OPC server. So if you'll remember, ours was numeric random in 32. Okay, the next thing I need to put in is location 1. This needs to correspond to the interface ID of my PI interface instance. So if you'll remember, this was 1. Next, I need to choose location 2. Location 2 is reserved for special data handling between the OPC server and the PI data archive. If some transformation needs to be done, it needs to be specified here. So again, please check out the PI interface for OPC DA user guide for more information. I'm not going to use any special data handling, so I'll leave it at 0. Next, I need to choose location 3. And this is really important because this specifies whether I'm creating an input point, so data collected from the OPC server going to the PI data archive, or an output point. An output point means having data from the PI data archive that I'm sending to my OPC server. So clearly I want to collect data from my OPC server, so I'm creating an input point. But there's actually 3 different types of input points that you can create for the PI interface for OPC DA. You can create an advise point, a polled point, and an event point. If you need more information on what the difference is between those 3, please check out the video on advise, polled, and event points. So I know that advise points are the most common and are the best choice for most scenarios, so I'm going to choose a location 3 of 1 to create an advise point. If you wanted to create a polled or event point, you would choose location 3 of 0. For an event point, you'd also have to go to the General tab and change the extended descriptor to identify what your trigger tag would be. So again, if you need more information, check out the PI interface for OPC DA user guide. Okay, so location 4 is where I'm going to specify which scan class my PI point belongs to. Again, remember the rules, which are that only advise points can go into scan class 1, and also never mixed input points of different types in the same scan class. For example, you can never put polled and advise points in the same scan class. So since my input point is advise, I can choose location 4 of 1. Okay, so now location 5. This is to specify an OPC deadband for advise points. So this is to make sure, let's say, that I don't want to collect very, very small changes on the data source. So in my case, I'm not going to set that, so I'm going to leave it for 0. Okay, so that's everything on the Classic tab. Now I can change it to the Security tab. So here is where I choose for point security who has access to see my PI point on the PI data archive, and for data security, who has access to the data in the PI point. So we need to make sure here that my PI interface's identity has read access to the PI point so that it can find it when it scans the PI data archive. So it does have read access, so we're good. For data security, we need to make sure that the PI interface's identity has write access so that it'll be able to write to my data. So this, I'm going to have to change it from read to write. Another important point here is that I'm at the point here where I haven't configured buffering. Once you configure buffering, it'll be your PI buffer that'll be writing to your data in the PI point. So I'll have to change this from the PI interface to the PI buffer identity. Okay, so that's everything. So now I can go ahead and click Save. Now I want to make sure that my PIPOINT is properly picked up by my PI interface instance. So I need to go back to my PI interface node, and I'm going to be watching my PI SDK log. Please note that it might take up to 2 minutes for your PI interface to pick up the new PIPOINT from the PI data archive. Alright, so it looks like it picked up my PIPOINT. So let's go back to PI System Management Tools to see if we're getting current data. So for that, we want to go under Data and Current Values, and we want to search for our PIPOINT. Perfect, so we actually see here that we're getting current data for our PIPOINT. Okay, so now I'm going to quickly show you the second way that you can create PIPOINTs, and we're going to be creating them in bulk, again using the PI OPC Client Tool. So let's go back to our PI Interface node and start up the PI OPC Client Tool. We'll connect to our OPC Server, create a group, and browse our OPC Server. Now this time, we're going to select as many items as we want to create on our PI Data Archive. So here I'm just going to be selecting a few items, but you can actually select up to 500 items per group and up to 20 groups. So once you've created your groups and added your items, you want to go to File and Save As. This will bring up this window. And here when we save, we're going to be creating a batch file and a CSV file. We're interested in the CSV file since this will contain all the information we need to create the PIPOINTs. But we need to select a location for both of these, so we need to hit the ellipses buttons. Once we do this, we should also change the point source to match the point source of our PI interface instance. Okay, and when we're ready, we'll go ahead and hit Save. Now I'm going to open up this CSV file in Excel where PI Builder has been enabled. So we see here that my PI OPC Client Tool has generated a CSV file that contains all the items that I selected with all the appropriate parameters that I need to be able to export this in bulk. So I'm going to be using PI Builder to create my PIPOINTs in bulk. And we can see that a lot of the parameters were filled in automatically and they were filled in correctly. So for example, all the point types were filled in correctly and the data handling that those need. We also have the correct point source and we have the correct instrument tags. But there are some things that we might need to change here. So for example, your tag names might be correct on your OPC server, but you might also need to modify them. So that's what I'm going to do since my tag names don't represent what I want to collect. Okay, perfect. Next, I also need to change location 3 and 4. As you'll remember, location 3 is for the type of input point, and location 4 is the scan class. So I want advised points in scan class 1, so I'll change everything in this column to 1, and everything in this column to 1. Perfect. And so for all the parameters that aren't listed here, the default will be selected. So if you'll remember, we actually had to change the default data security on the tag we created in SMT. So let me import that one in a separate sheet. So what I can do is just copy over the data security from this sheet into my tag list, and then apply this to every single item in my column. Perfect. So now I'm ready to export this list, and this should create the PIPOINTs on the PI Data Archive. So I'll go ahead and hit Publish, and select Create. All right, perfect. So now we can go back once again to our PI interface node to see if the PI points have been picked up. Okay, the PI points have been picked up. So now I can go to PI System Management Tools and search for my PI points. Awesome, so now I can see that I'm getting current data for all the PI points that I created.